Over the years, I have tried Pamelor, Nortriptyline, Wellbutrin, Zoloft, Paxil, Abilify, Adderall, Effexa, Celexa, Zyprexa. At one point, my doctor said, let's just try drugs that rhyme. Thank you, Dr. Seuss.
Comedian Gary Gulman makes jokes about his depression.
Thank you.
Because he has to.
I was so clearly in distress. My hands were shaking. I acknowledged that I was sick, and I started to write jokes about it because that's the most comfortable I am is when I'm being funny. So I started saying things like, have you ever gotten recognized in the psych ward?
So it's a true story. You were recognized in the psych ward?
Yes. Yes. The day I got there, a man came up to me and he said, oh, I won't tell anybody, but you're Gary Gulman, right? Am I crazy or are you Gary Gulman?
I grew up at a time the definition of manhood was so narrow. You were either Clint Eastwood or you were Richard Simmons. There was nothing in between. There were no Paul Rudds. No kind-eyed Mark Ruffalo's. You had to be so hard.
His new film, The Great Depression, is a brutally honest chronicle of his journey back 2 years ago from a near-fatal battle with treatment-resistant depression.
You said you were afraid you would never get better.
Yeah, I wasn't communicating. I didn't feel good about anything. There was nothing I looked forward to, and I spent a lot of time trying to think of painless suicides. Yeah.
He was forced to step back from comedy, admitted himself to the hospital twice, and more.
My psychiatrist is an advocate for and an expert in something called electroconvulsive therapy, which used to be called electroshock therapy, but they felt electroshock was not quite horrifying enough. They said, yes, electroshock is disturbing, but I feel like we're soft-selling the convulsions.
How important is it to you to destigmatize these things, like the hospital, like electroconvulsive therapy?
I think I have a responsibility and an obligation, but also I'm so grateful for feeling good that I want to share this, that if people feel the way I felt, can feel better, I would do everything in my power to get that information to them so they'll try it and so that they won't be afraid.
You actually joke about suicide notes.
Yes, yes, and I was concerned about that.
I really feel in some way that my aversion to essays has saved my life again and again, because anytime I've contemplated suicide, I've thought, you gotta leave a note. I'm not spending the last hour of my life doing something I've dreaded throughout it.
I didn't want to trivialize people who leave suicide notes or suicidal, so we actually checked that with the National Foundation for Suicide Prevention to make sure that it wasn't insensitive.
Was that the closest to the edge?
Yeah, I think so. I think that was the closest to the edge. And also, there was one joke where I said that I would compare my childhood to Charlie Brown's if Snoopy had died, and I said, that's too dark and really sad.
So I laughed at that joke. My wife went, oh.
Yeah, it's so sad.
The only antidepressants we had access to in the 1970s and 80s pretty much was snap out of it. And what have you got to be depressed about? That was the second leading brand of antidepressant.
Were you convinced that you could make mental illness funny?
I was convinced at that point that even if I didn't make a mental illness funny, it would be a valiant effort, sort of a quixotic effort, that even if I failed miserably, this was something that took some courage. And quickly it became not even an act of courage because it worked so well.
So well that he landed the HBO special, so well that people are laughing a lot, and so well that he's having an impact on people's lives right before our eyes.
Sister Brother both had a severe depression, so I talk about you.
Oh,
you're
all right.
Inspiration.
Okay, thank you. That's so nice. Thank you. That doesn't happen every day, but yeah.
See?
But occasionally.
You say the first time you watched the special, once it was all cut together,
yeah,
you cried.
It hit me that it was over and I survived and now I'm thriving.
How do you know you're going to be okay?
Well, I don't, but I am optimistic and it doesn't dissipate. If anything, the work and the talks that I've given have given me more energy, and I can't thank God, the universe, the computer simulation that we're living in, whatever gets you out of bed, I can't thank that entity enough for saving me.
I am so glad. Are you kidding me that I stuck around for this? Oh.